Hello dear students, welcome to your channel Visual Physics Tutor, the best place to learn the concepts of physics in the most easiest and finest way. So today we will be dealing with the derivation electric field at the equatorial point of a dipole. For this we have to consider a dipole system. So here we take a minus Q and a plus Q, which is separated by a distance 2a. Let this point be considered to be at point A and let this point be considered to be at point B. Now let the center of the dipole be taken as O. Now we can say that exactly along the equatorial line, let us consider a point P such that the distance from point P to A is x and point P to point B is also x. So now this is in the equatorial line, so we can join this and let this point P be at a distance r from the center O. Now we have seen that from point A to point B, let the distance be x, and similarly let the point B to point P, that is also x. Now let the angle formed here be theta and let the angle formed be here be also theta. Now we can assume that at point P we keep a test charge. Now you had learned in the previous classes that the test charge we consider is almost a positive charge and it is vanishingly small and it will have negligible effect on the source charge, but source charge will have a super effect on the test charge. So now if this is a positive test charge kept at point P, we can just try to analyze what will be the effect at point A due to the negative charge. Now negative charge is the source charge, so definitely the source charge being stronger will pull the test charge from point P towards it. So I can give the direction this way, that means it is an attractive force. So now we can say that there is an electric field at point P due to a charge at A. So we can write here electric field at P due to charge at A. Now this is given by E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by x square. Now this being an attractive force, it is attracted towards A. So we can write here, now this is electric field at due to point A, so it is towards A. Now similarly we can find the electric field at P due to charge at B. So it is electric field at P due to charge at B. Now you can see here at B we have a positive charge, that is plus Q, and at P we have kept a positive test charge. Now this charge kept at B will actually repel the test charge in the forward direction. So we can see here now the charge at point B will repel the charge at point P in this direction. So this here I can write this is EA and here this is now EB. So now I can write here EB is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by x square, and it is away from B. So we can write it is away from B. Now we know that the electric field at A is equal to electric field at B. That means EA is equal to EB. Now we have to resolve EA and EB as shown in the diagram. So how do we resolve this? So we can see that on resolving here, the one component of EA will be in this direction. So here I can write it as EA cos theta. Why? Because this angle will be theta here and this angle will be theta here. So this is EA cos theta. Now similarly, here this will be EA sin theta. Now we can again resolve for the EB. Now you can see that EB can be again resolved one in this direction. So here I will get EB cos theta. And one in this direction, that is EB sin theta. Now this EA and EB has been resolved as shown in the diagram. So we can find the net field at P due to the vertical components. So let us now calculate the net field at P due to the vertical component. So it is EA sin theta minus EB sin theta is equal to 0, because you can see they are acting in the opposite directions. So I can write here now EA sin theta minus EB sin theta is equal to 0. So now the net field at P due to the horizontal components. Now this was due to the vertical component. So now I can write net field at P due to horizontal components. So that is E is equal to, now you can see here in the horizontal component is this direction. So here EA cos theta and EB cos theta acts in the same direction. So we can add it up. So E is equal to EA cos theta plus EB cos theta. Now previously we had already written here the electric field at A is will be equal to the electric field at B. So this is the equation, that means EA is equal to EB. Now since EA is equal to EB, I can substitute here and write it as 2EA cos theta. Why? Because here EA is equal to EB. Now we can consider the triangle APO. So from triangle APO. So look at the figure, it's A, P and O. So here you can take cos theta. So now the whole length of the dipole is 2A. So from A to O, it will be point A to O, it will be A, and again O to B, again it will be A. So I can write here now cos theta is equal to A by X. Cos theta is equal to A by X. Now we can substitute the value of cos theta in this equation. So we can write here E is equal to two into, now instead of EA I can write 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by x square. So it is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by x square. Now instead of cos theta I can write it as a by x, so into a by x. Now from the formula for electric dipole moment, you know that P is equal to Q into 2A. So since P is equal to Q into 2A, we can substitute it here. So we get here E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P by X cube. Now we can take the triangle APO again. In the triangle APO, if we apply Pythagoras theorem, we know that x square is equal to r square plus a square. So I can write here x square is equal to r square plus a square. Now this can be alternatively written as x is equal to r square plus a square raised to half. Now if we write this as x cube, so we can write therefore x cube is equal to r square plus a square the whole raised to 3 by 2. We can write here E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P by, now instead of this x cube we can write here r square plus a square the whole raised to 3 by 2. Now if the dipole length is very small, we can neglect a square. So if dipole length is very small, neglect a square. So now this equation can be written as E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P by, now you can see here this a square can be neglected, so it is r square into 3 by 2, the 2 and 2 gets cancelled, so we get here r cube. Now in the vector form this can be written as E vector is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P by r cube dot r cap. Now on the equatorial line of the electric dipole, P vector and E vector are antiparallel and the angle between them, the theta, is equal to 180 degree. So on the equatorial line, of electric dipole, P vector and E vector are antiparallel and the angle between them, theta, is 180 degree. Now you can see that there is a relationship existing between the electric field when it is along the axial line and the electric field when it is along the equatorial line. So this can be written as E axial by E equatorial is equal to, now you can substitute the values, that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught to 2p by r cube, the whole divided by, it's 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught p by r cube. So on cancelling out you will get a term which is equal to 2. That means E axial is equal to twice E equatorial. So E axial is equal to twice E equatorial. So, hope you have understood this derivation, and really thanks.